In Rainbow Six Extraction, we've learned that the Archaeans never give up. So long as React remains the only line of defense, neither will we. This is Director Eliza Cohen, and I'm here to give you the brief on the Maelstrom Protocol. Maelstrom Protocol is not for new recruits, nor for the ill-prepared. Even the most accomplished operators approach Maelstrom with utmost caution. The intensity is palpable as soon as your squad of three enters the first of 9 subzones. You'll be facing dangerous parasitic threats, while the clock ticks down, to complete increasingly difficult objectives. Your mission is to get as far as you can through the 9 subzones and extract with as many completed objectives as possible. Every subzone has an extraction point, so if you and your squad can't continue, you can extract and bank your score. In Maelstrom Protocol, you'll find that each subzone has a mandatory map objective for you and your squad to complete. You'll have a time limit to complete each objective, but that time progressively gets reduced with every subzone, starting with 15 minutes, down to only 8 minutes at the end. If you can't complete a map objective, you'll still be able to move to the next subzone. However, you won't receive as many points or XP. That's not all that's challenging about Maelstrom Protocol. Here are aspects of the protocol that make it the most difficult mode in Extraction. Number 1. Scaling difficulty. You'll run into dangerous enemies right off the bat in Maelstrom Protocol, but it doesn't end there. Your enemies get stronger over time, and Archaeans unleash it all in the last subzone. Number 2. Random modifiers. You'll encounter one random parasite mutation in each subzone. From blinding spore carriers to caustic sprawl that inflicts damage when you walk over it, to cloaked Archaeans that can get the jump on you, these mutations add another layer of complexity that will keep you on your toes. Number 3. Scarcity of resources. You'll find that field supplies become increasingly scarce the further you progress in Maelstrom Protocol. Medkits aren't available after Subzone 3. Ability recharges aren't in sight after Subzone 6. Ammo supplies are nowhere to be found after Subzone 8. In Subzone 9, there are no field supplies. You'll need to make do with what you have. Number 4. MIA operators. If you lose an operator during Maelstrom Protocol, you won't be able to rescue them until the incursion in Maelstrom is over. All this can sound rather daunting for you and your squad, but with the right training, efficient communication with your squad, and a little bit of luck, you'll extract safely out of Subzone 9 in Maelstrom Protocol. Here are some tips on how to do so. Here with React, knowledge is power. Learn all the various behaviors, strengths, and weaknesses of the Archaeans. You'll then know how to best engage them. It'll also benefit your team to know each other's operator abilities. Figure out optimal weapon loadouts and how to best support each squad member. This all comes down to practice. Throughout your many incursions, make sure to match up different operators in a squad and experiment with complementary skills to see what works best for each situation. As an operator with React, teamwork is everything. Your success or failure will come from your ability to work together. Communicate with your squad. Verify that everyone knows their roles, the plan of attack, and can respond to sudden changes in the field, preventing worst-case scenarios. If you find yourself without a mic and voice chat, use the chat wheel to communicate with your squad. Adopting the right tactical approach will be critical in Maelstrom Protocol. Evaluate your options carefully. If a full-on assault isn't working, you might want to try a stealthier approach. Remember that all field resources get scarcer the further you go. Managing your supplies will be key to extracting with the greatest number of completed objectives. Once you've completed an objective, don't move to the next subzone right away. Use the remaining time to explore the area and find the refill stations. Whenever you can, take the time to boost your squad's HP. Some of the biggest lessons can come from your mistakes or failed incursions. You'll want to optimize your tactics from one incursion to another to increase your chances of going as far as possible. And lastly, keep this keyword in mind: extraction. Sometimes, it's better for your squad to extract and bank the points than to try your luck by delving further in Maelstrom Protocol. Maelstrom gives operators the chance to not only display their skills, but to receive rewards for their enduring efforts. Each time Maelstrom Protocol is in effect for your squad, you'll earn an incursion score based on how far you've managed to get with your team, how well you've completed objectives, and how well you performed individually. Successful extractions will grant a significant boost to your score. You'll want that boost, as it'll influence your Maelstrom class placement. There are a total of 5 Maelstrom classes: Bronze, Silver, Gold, Platinum, and Diamond. Each class will reward you with a unique headgear that you can wear with pride to show how far you've gone. As icing on the cake, you'll earn credits on a weekly basis for your own personal use in the shop. The greater the risk, the greater the reward. That's all I have for you right now. Operate as one, don't leave anyone behind, and you'll see this through together.